Hello everyone, welcome to Design Bytes. Today let's see how to animate vector drawables using ShapeShifter. First, let's start editing name and duration for the animation and then import the SVG icon. Once you have imported the SVG into ShapeShifter, let's all be good designers and have a proper namings for groups and paths inside our vector. Sometimes ShapeShifter might miss the colors you want to have for your icon, so try to check the fill color for the vectors and change it accordingly. As I want to achieve rotation animation with this icon, we have to create a group first because rotation can only apply for a group. So you can see how I am creating a group and moving the gear icon inside the group. Now you can see how to set a rotation animation on the group. Select the rotation and increase the duration for it to 800 milliseconds. You can set the interpolation from value and to value. And then you can see how the animation works. Oops, looks like something went wrong here. Yes, you're right. We have to set pivot X and pivot Y as the center of the icon. So we can see how to set pivot X and pivot Y. As the icon is 24x24, I'm setting it as 12x12 so that the pivot center is at the center of the icon. Now we can see how it's animating once I just change pivot X. Let's change pivot Y and set the animation to 800 milliseconds. Now you can see how the icon animates after setting pivot to center. That's what we want to achieve. We are almost done. While we are rotating the icon, we also want to change the color of the icon so that we have a proper animation. So we want to change the fill color for the end state. So let's see how to change the fill color. I'm just setting the duration as 800 milliseconds. I'm changing the to value of the gear icon to whatever the color I want to have here. It's a purple color. And I also want to change the color for the center circle. So I'm doing the same. I'm repeating the same process. I'm changing my duration to 800. Changing the to color to blue. And that's it. We're almost done. Now let's see how it works completely. Let's run the animation. Let's run the animation in slow motion. Yes, that's what we want to achieve. Thanks for watching.